We stay on side, stay on side. Hey, sorry.
Well, as Andrew Pollard was the one coming away with the ball, Des Wood blowing his whistle for half time. St. Michael's leading by that try by Mark Bollard after 5 minutes, converted by Noel Reid. Score coming up, confirmation there, 7 points to 3. Don't go away, we'll have the second half coming to you from Donnybrook just after this.
Schools Rugby on Setanta Sports in association with Griffith College Dublin, a complete learning experience.
Tell you more about life on the pig's back. You can make massive savings on your weekly shopping. Just print your coupons and present them at the supermarket. Action! You can get 2-for-1 rentals on videos, DVDs and games. Get away with a great offer on a pig's back holiday, flight or short break. Pigsback.com. Are you on it?
Let the sunshine into your house with out-home conservatories and sunrooms. The ultimate addition to your lifestyle and your property. With styles to suit your home at prices to suit your budget. More space, more light, more luxury. Call Out Home now for a free no-obligation survey and quotation. Or visit our showrooms at Airport Road, Dublin, beside the Coachman's Inn. Buy now and get an air conditioning unit worth €1,200 free. You don't need to score 500 points to study law. Portobello College Dublin, one of Ireland's leading independent colleges, offers an internationally recognised law degree, validated by King's Inns and the Incorporated Law Society. Located in the centre of Dublin, Portobello College offers you personal attention, outstanding facilities and a wonderful social life. Try law, try business, try computing, try Portobello College Dublin. Portobello College Dublin, be your own judge.
Wavon, make the right connections.
Here's an offer from Windsor that'll set your pulse racing. Buy a brand new Nissan Micra and get comprehensive insurance absolutely free. Buy a brand new Almera and you'll get up to €2,000 worth of extras absolutely free. Or choose a brand new Primera and enjoy a color reversing camera and satellite navigation. Three incredible offers available in all Windsor dealers now. Windsor Motors, Ireland's favourite dealers.
Wake up, people. Jim here is a nice guy. He's stuck in a rut, doesn't like one thing about his bank. Does he switch? Nah, he needs a wake-up call.
Why keep paying these bank charges when it's now easier to switch to Permanent TSB's great new current account? Call our dedicated switcher team now on 1890 500 192. Remember, that's 1890 500 192.
Permanent TSB. Banking only better.
Schools Rugby on Satanta Sports in association with Griffith College Dublin, a complete learning experience.
Well, Des Wood has just blown the whistle and called them back in, and I can see him. He actually tried to catch that ball down there, and even he dropped it. So the conditions really are horrendous. There's very little grass on this pitch, and when the water has been pouring down, it makes it very slippy. A great credit to both sides at the moment. They're putting on a good performance, finding it difficult to move the ball out along the back lines. But it'll be interesting to see, because certainly Monkstown need to move the ball. We haven't seen very much of their two centres, Gary Foley and Killian Jenkinson, who are two key players for Monkstown. But Stephen Malone and Freddie Meegan have controlled things at 9 and 10 for Michaels, and their pack has also played very well in that first half. But now, this is Shane Grenell, and he had a very good first half. Stephen Murphy with a cracker of a tackle. Well, Monkstown starting off with gusto. This is Gary Foley, the Monkstown captain. He's going to have to lead now from the front. Stephen Roberts. Good solid defence by Michaels. But again, it's back on the mile, and there's a hand coming over there. Yes. Very bright start by Monkstown, the big number 8, Shane Grenell, the vice captain. But that's a great tackle by Stephen Murphy. Gary Foley deciding that it's within his kicking range.
Okay, Blues, is the penalty stands, please.
We saw Noel Reid with the conversion from that position earlier on in the first half, midway between the 22 and the halfway line. Gets underneath it well. Hasn't got the distance. No, it just falls short, but it was a very good attempt.
Make sure they're behind you. Play one.
No Reid with the restart, but Shane Grenell, probably the only error he's made in this game, just couldn't quite hold on to that one.
Back we come, gentlemen, back we come, please. Back we come, please. Gentlemen, gentlemen. Back we come. Blue, close the gap, please. Wait, please. Touch. Thank you. Four.
Freddie Meegan feeding the scrum, but that one's against the head. Now there's a turnover for Monkstown.
Okay.
Gary Foley has got in at out half. Down as far as Stephen Murphy, and a good block down by Owen Cunningham for Monkstown. Now, what can they do? They back to the number 6, Barry Dunn.
No hands! That's a rough!
There's a lot of hands going in there, yes, well. The ball was there, it was available, it was sitting there for quite a while. And Gary Foley this time decides to go for the line-out. It's a much brighter start by Monkstown in the second half. Their line-out has been working well.
Sorry?
Particularly with Richard Ivers. Shane Grenell has been very much to the fore in this pack. And again, they go short, go to the front. Now they set up the driving maul. They're doing well, but it's gone down, so they're going to have to use that ball.
Still holding advantage.
Killian Horgan out to Gary Foley. Killian Jenkinson, no way through for him, well tackled down. Ben Graham, solid in the defence. But again, it's Monkstown, but again, good defensive play by St. Michael's. Back they'll go for the penalty. And now Monkstown. 5 minutes into the
for collapsing the mall. Two
second
blue.
Half.
So here, boys.
Right back over in the corner. He's giving the penalty for collapsing the mall.
On the line, please, yeah. Okay, ball down.
About 5 metres in from touch. Now they've got an important decision to make. We'll play held up for a moment. I think Shane Grinnell has gone down for injury on that 22 metre. Yeah, there he is. Well, whatever Derek Kelleher, Jerry Berry and Declan Keegan said to Monkstown at half-time, they've come out an awful lot brighter. And in particular, Shane Grinnell has been very obvious with his surging runs. And of course, the conditions requiring that both sides depend on their packs. Who played in the second row last year on the JCT. And in fact, his brother Paul was on the senior cup side. He also played at number 8. And he's certainly warm in that suit, that's okay? For sure.
You okay, 8, yes? What's his on? Let's play water. Off we go. Yeah. The gentleman's scrum is called.
Grinnell is ready to take his place back at the back of the scrum. Very important player, very important moment this for Monkstown. And Monkstown now have to hold their defence solid, getting a good drive on in the scrum, pushing CBC backwards. They pick Monkstown, picking at the back now, look to set up the drive towards the Michael's goal line. Grinnell at the tick of the action. It's there for Monkstown. Popping the ball up, knocked forward in the tackle by Gary Foley. Good tackling by Alex Byrne, the ball coming off the chest of Gary Foley, and so it'll be a scrum down to Michaels.
Stay on side 9, Rick. Okay, quick. Release the ball.
Michaels picking at the back through Andrew Pollard. Now they need to clear the lines, and Noel Reid kicks it, doesn't find touch on the counter-attack. Owen Cunningham for Monkstown. Monkstown using the fringes, driving around the edges. Picking up the little bits of yardage as they march their way towards the Michael's goal line.
Too many bodies on the floor. No scrum team going forward. Yes, please, gentlemen, wait, please. Touch.
Still 7 points to 3 in favour of St. Michael's. Stephen Roberts, Killian Horgan. Now Monkstown looking to move the ball out. There's Alex King coming into the back line. Out to Owen Gallagher. Good, solid defensive tackling by St. Michael's. Mark Bollard putting in that tackle in defence, but still the possession is there for CBC Monkstown.
Still penalty advantage.
Still the advantage, Remy's hand up, a little sniper on the edges and he's over. Stephen Roberts saw the little bit of space, good scrum half play, saw his opportunity, nipped through the gap. And Monkstown with their first try of the game, look at that, that little dummy stepping inside, Ben Graham caught on the hop. Lovely bit of play by the scrum half. And all the pressure by Monkstown in this second half, resulting in points. The conversion now to come from Killian Horgan. underneath it well, gets good height, good distance, but just sliding past the far upright. It was a good attempt by Killian Horgan. So 1 point separates the sides. Monkstown for the first time going into the lead. 8 points to seven. And supporters with something to cheer about. Michaels have been a little bit slow to start the second half. Noel Reid opting to kick the ball straight at Stephen Devine, who does well to hold on to it, but the possession turned over to Michaels. To just about halfway line. Andrew Pollard looking to throw to Mark Kelly at the front of the lineout. Doesn't quite come off. There's a turnover there. It's back on the Monkstown side.
But it's over, play on.
Good little bit of play by Gary Foley, the Monkstown captain, who's gone in at out half. He's steadying the ship a little bit, working well with scrum half. Stephen Roberts bringing play midway between the Michaels 22 and the halfway line, throw to the back of the lineout. Oh, that's very well taken by Alex Byrne for Michaels. Stephen Malone under an awful lot of pressure from the Monkstown forwards. Well, Steve Malone found himself quite isolated there. He was under all sorts of pressure from the Monkstown pack coming through. And Michael's guilty of going in at the side. Another penalty to Monkstown as they begin to turn the screw.
Just on the ball, yeah.
So now this is Killian Horgan to extend the lead to 4 points. Hits it well, just pulls it ever so slightly past the near upright and wide. Well, that's one he would have liked to have gotten. Well, certainly if the conditions were a lot better, he wouldn't have any difficulty with it, but very difficult to keep the non-kicking foot solid on the ground. And so the score remains, 8 points to seven in favour of Monkstown. And 13 minutes played in the second half. Gary Foley sets it up for Monkstown. The ball, the pop ball back inside to Shane Gradell. He makes the adjustment, but the vice-captain, he's very strong indeed, still drives forward. Back to the captain, Gary Foley. Stephen Murphy now. He's under pressure. He needs the support of his pack. The Michaels pack do well. They get wrestle their way out on defence. That's a good bit of play by St. Michaels. Now they need to find their touch. Stephen Malone doesn't quite do it. This is Owen Cunningham coming inside. Andrew Pollard is through very quickly to clean up for St. Michaels.
Nothing, boys. Ball lost forward by two. Scrum ridge. Okay, substitutions, boys. Watch off.
The rain again pouring down in Donnybrook.
No, it's a break, yeah. Watch it off.
Looks like St. Michael's are going to make a substitution. I see Stephen Malone heading towards the touchline over on the far side. And yes, they are making a substitution on the far side. Jared DC coming on instead of Stephen Malone.
Right to your rows, please. Touch, engage.
Good drive on the scrum by St. Michael's.
Slow.
Little chip kick by Gary Foley. Oh, and Stephen Murphy does very well indeed to keep his eye on that ball.
Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet. Here we go.
No reads now. He needs to find a good touch. Michaels need to get down into the Monkstown half of the pitch. They really have been camped down in their own half for most of the second half. And in these conditions, very, very difficult to get out. For all credit to Monkstown, they've come out in the second half and they really have taken this game to Michaels. Andrew Pollard looking to try and go over the end of the line out, but it goes crooked. Probably not the best of options in these conditions. Picked up by Alex, by Barry Dunn.
Let it go. It's okay, it's the no hurt. Not on blue. First pick up, knock on. What was out? That was okay, yeah, but he knocked on the pick up. Wait, gentlemen, please wait, please touch. Again.
Good attacking position for Monkstown. Move it over to the far side. This is Gary Foley, opts to kick. Little grubber kick and finally a very good touch. Just right on the Monkstown goal line, just about 5 metres out. Are the Monks on the Michaels goal line, so all the pressure now on Michaels.
On the five, gentlemen, set on the five. Count your numbers.
This time, Michaels thrown to the front of the line-out and do a lot better. Jared DC with the kick.
Borderline on the front.
Yeah.
Okay, let's. Yeah, it's kind of just a good guy, isn't it? We'll try and get some. Same again, what's the corner? Counting numbers, boys, we're okay, we're full set.
Stephen Boucher thrown to the line out.
Stay outside, Red. Stay outside.
Andrew Pollard goes down and cleans it up for Michaels. DC with the pass. Back to Noel Reid. Finds a good touch.
Same again.
Second year in the JCT for Reid. He's a very good player. Freddie Began has gone out to out half.
Turn away, gentlemen, turn away.
DC's gone in at scrum half.
Substitution, Ray, watch off.
Ronan Kearney coming on.
What number
for Monkstown.
Number one is gone out.
Just waiting to see who's gone off for Monkstown.
Okay, watch this on, play ball. Hold.
That's good possession by the Monkstown pack. Setting up this drive in more of a steam coming off the players as they drive towards the Michaels goal line. But wrestled away. Very well done by Alex Byrne for St. Michaels.
Okay.
DC, oh my goodness, dangerous to move the ball in these conditions on your own goal line, and a lot of pressure now on St. Michael's.
No hands, no hands.
They still have the possession now. They need to run away and move out with this ball. Andrew Pollard does well for the Blues.
It's all in.
Well, there's a turnover, 2 months down. Now they've got men outside. Can they move the ball across? Oh, that pass looked like it would have went forward from Shea Grenell. Referee lets it go on, but the hand has gone up. Holding the ball in the tackle. So relief for Michaels. Stephen Devine has gone off the Monkstown team.
Take the lead, try that scene out, yeah.
We've got just under 10 minutes to go now in this Junior Cup match. 8-7 in favour of CBC Monkstown. And it's Monkstown who are doing all of the attacking, but there's Alex Byrne. He's had a very good game for St. Michael's, taking that ball, a very difficult ball at the end of the line-out. Now, what can they do to move themselves out of their own half? DC, the scrum half. But again, it's turned over to the Monkstown pack, who've managed to wrestle a lot of ball away from St. Michael's. DC taps. Ball lost forward. Advantage to Monkstown.
Wait.
CBC Monkstown lost to St. Michael's in the JCT in 2001 and 2002, so they'll be looking to pull one back in this game as we move to 8.5 minutes left. Referee looking to the touchline. It looked for a moment as if we were going to have a substitution. Yes, indeed, for St. Michael's on comes Chris O'Connor. On instead of Michael Andreasen.
Okay, gentlemen, watch his back line. Let's wait, please. He's coming down to the red scrum. Wait, gentlemen. Well, no, back off now. Touch, and yes. Stay outside. Let's play it, please, play it.
Grenell picks again at the back. Monkstown creating the overlap. That ball just bouncing off Andrew Pollard's hand.
It's enough, guy.
Nice little bit of a move by Monkstown that created the overlap, but Pollard was very quick to break up potential danger.
Stay outside, please.
Gideon Morgan with his kick back over to the far corner, putting again. Michael's back on the back foot.
Yep.
And you'd have to say that the signs are looking ominous for St. Michael's if they can't get out of their own half. Richard Ivers again at the front of the line-out for CBC Monkstown. He's done very well, been very solid. And they get the driving maul on.
Stay at the back, they come, stay on side.
With some doubt. Points. Gary Foley. Can't get around the tackle of Charles Lorigan.
Stay in, lead us forward. We're off forward.
So St. Michael's, who had a very good first half. Really, the tide has turned in the second half, and it's the Monkstown supporters are the ones who certainly can cheer at the moment. This is their captain, Gary Foley. But a very good tackle put on him by Charles Donegan. Keane Stacey coming on instead of Robert Cruz Callaghan.
Okay, the watch is back on. We wait for these gentlemen. Go, back up.
blue.
No, gentlemen, just missed some beast. That's the second one. Wait for the card, please.
Close touch.
There you go. Okay.
DC feeds the scrum. Picked to the back by Pollard.
So look, please.
Well, this is the way Munster Michaels will have to play it, to edge forward, their way out, keep that ball under control. That was a good bit of play by Pollard.
Okay, this is worse. We'll step out.
For St. Michaels, but
the
clock is running down. We've just got 5 minutes plus a little bit of injury time. 8 points to seven in favour of Monkstown.
No, okay, listen to the call, gentlemen. Blue square on. Touch. Engage. Okay, scrum half feed it. Don't interfere.
Steam rising off the packs.
He's gone.
It stopped raining temporarily for the moment.
Lost forward. One lost forward by Blue. Scrum red.
But really, the pressure is relentless from that one sound pack.
Yeah, time off. It's time off for release. Are you okay? Yep. Okay, time is back on.
Well, Monkstown had a disappointing start to their cup campaign with their seniors losing out to St. Mary's by 20 points to nil. But at this stage, it looks like their juniors are looking good to go through to the next round.
Onside, gentlemen, onside.
Well, however, anything can happen in schools rugby, as well known.
No, he's okay. Tackled. They're holding on the floor. It's released.
So now Michaels have to get out of their own half. Reed finds the touch.
Okay.
They have the line out and they need the possession now from this. They need to set up good control. Pollard needs to hit his jumpers. They break it down to three men in the line out. Conroe Sullivan. Tim Keane McKenna, and they look to throw over the back. Looked a little bit crooked, but referee Des Wood lets it go. Michael's okay, now looking to move the ball. This is Noel Reid with the dummy tackle. Killian Jenkinson puts in the tackle on him, but Michael's on cue moving into the Monkstown half of the field, but the ball is turned over. They couldn't keep control of it.
Scrum advantage.
Well, it goes into touch straight, but it goes off the hand of a Monkstown player. Michael's not getting the rub of the green. Two and a half minutes to go on the clock.
The tail ace. Just hold it off. Hold it off.
Quick, get that, hurry up!
Charles Lonigan just tying his shoelace.
Okay, watch out.
He starts his watch.
Yes,
go. They need a steal. They need a steal in this line out if they're going to get hold of the ball. They do. Our Michaels have it.
Looking for advantage.
Now, what can Michael do? They look to it. Out no lead. He just cheats back. It's a good at least. Attacking back. Home for Amstown. Now. What choice do they have to use to move it quickly? They look to set it up. Big number three, Mark Kelly. This is Freddie.
Great, backwards, clear.
All those backwards. Stephen Mercy, Mercy clears out the back.
Offside.
Offside, unfortunately. Man was in front, so he'll be scrummed down to Montown. Minute, injury time left, you can see there's the slight touch. But it gives the advantage to Montown. Fully with the kick. Now Michaels need to move this ball. They need to find a little bit of Stephen Murphy. He beats the first tackle, but won't get around Shane Bell. Keith McKenna sets it up for Michaels. Now, this is the number two, Chris O'Connor. DC. Megan throws a long pass to Mark Bollard. Good pass, but the Monkstown defence is holding solid.
Tackle away!
Still, okay. Michaels have the possession. Still, they drive forward. Monkstown now don't need to give away any penalties. Michaels again look to move the ball. Chris O'Connor. That ball has been knocked forward as we move into injury time.
And forward.
Referee has a look at his watch.
2 minutes.
Well, you heard him there. 2 minutes left of injury time. So anxious moments now for both sides.
Wait. Touch.
Well, there's a lot of hearts beating there. That extra little bit faster in the Michael stand. As I say, there are amongst town too. Now, this is Gary Foley. He puts a kick up, well taken down by Kian McKenna. As the pitch really cutting up in front of us. Absolutely almost impossible for these guys to keep their footing. But yet they do. Chris O'Connor, he's been very much to the fore since he's come on for Michaels. Drive as they drive now over the Monkstown 10-metre line.
Okay, block the floor, right blue. It's a rough.
Now they've set it up. DC to Meegan. They've got the extra man over the far side. Really, this is their last chance, but Monkstown defence holding the line. Michael still with the possession.
Outside.
Conor O'Sullivan driving down along the fringes.
He's okay, he's following. Outside.
Now they still finding that extra little bit of yard. And Michael's just inching their way towards the Monkstown 22. Keeping the ball tight, keeping it safe.
No hands, go away! Go away!
But very good discipline from Monkstown.
He's going
at the moment, but still it's Michaels.
Accidental offside, man in front. Think they're going again. Scrum.
It'll be the scrum down to Monkstown. They need to put this ball away, the clock running down. Accidental offside.
Great gentlemen, touch. Hey, you. Come half ready, please.
Back it goes to Gary Foley. Doesn't find the touch. So now Michaels, probably with their last opportunity to attack the Monkstown goal line. No read, but he can't get outside the tackle. Referee looks at his watch, blows the whistle, and Monkstown, CBC Monkstown, are the ones that will go through into the next round, winning this game here in a rain-soaked, mud-laden Donnybrook. It was all Michaels in the first half. They looked very strong indeed. Bollard and Reid with the conversion, Bollard with the try, Killian Hogan with the penalty, but then in the second half, Roberts with the try, and in the end, it's the favourites coming into this game, CBC Monkstown, getting out winners, 8-7, and they're the ones that go through into the next round.
Schools Rugby on Satanta Sports in association with Griffith College.